I will talk in details about Sputnik V vaccine in today's video. I will cover the overall efficacy of the vaccine, safety of the vaccine, efficacy on different variants like Alpha, Beta, Gamma and Delta. Sputnik V is developed in Russia and it shows 91.6% efficacy in its phase 3 trial data. The trial was done with about 22,000 participants. We all know that when we are vaccinated, we develop antibodies against the virus. When we are not vaccinated, the virus can enter our cell and thus we get infected. But when antibodies are present, we do not get infected by the virus because the antibodies stop the cell from entering the virus. And this kind of antibodies which stop the cell from entering the virus are called neutralizing antibodies. So, it was found that good amount of neutralizing antibody was developed with help of Sputnik V vaccine. Another arm of immune system is the T cell response against virus. In this case, T cell response was also very good. So, overall, Sputnik V seems to be a very good vaccine against SARS-CoV-2. In a study on 5,000 participants in Bahrain, it showed an efficacy of 94.3%. In UAE, the efficacy was found to be 97.8% against COVID cases. The vaccine was given to 81,000 participants and it showed 100% efficacy against severe COVID. In India, the efficacy is found to be 90%. So, in general, we can see that the vaccine has an efficacy of about 90%. That is pretty good, isn't it? The vaccine is made on well-known platform, that is adenovirus vector platform. Like Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine, which is known as Covishield in India, and Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Here, they have used two kinds of adenovirus, human adenovirus 26 and human adenovirus 5, which are given as two doses. And the doses are given 21 days apart. According to the developers, this heterologous adenovirus approach will give more immune response like the vaccine cocktail studies ongoing with Pfizer-AstraZeneca vaccine. There are various studies which says that the vaccine is safe. In phase 3 trial data, there were 4 deaths in the vaccinated group and 1 death in the placebo group. But none of the deaths were related to the vaccine. So till now, it seems that Sputnik V is highly efficacious, it is safe, and it has a good antibody response. Recently, an article was published which saw the neutralizing activity of sera from Sputnik V vaccinated people on different variants of concern. Basically, they took the blood sample from fully vaccinated people 1 month after vaccination. Then they saw whether the antibodies present in the blood can stop the virus from infecting our cell. Basically, they wanted to find whether neutralizing antibodies are present against the different variants. In case of Alpha variant, which was first discovered in United Kingdom, there was no significant reduction in the neutralization. It gave same protection like the original variant. In case of Beta variant, which was found in South Africa first, there was a 3.1-fold reduction in neutralization. In case of Gamma variant, which was found in Brazil first, there was 2.8-fold reduction in neutralization. In Argentina, where the P1 variant, that is the Gamma variant, was dominant, it was found that 99.65 participants developed specific antibody against this P1 variant. It was 42 days after the second dose, and 88.5% participants developed P1 specific antibodies 14 days after the first dose. In case of Delta variant, which was first found in India, there was 2.5-fold reduction in neutralization. It was found that the vaccine is 90% effective against Delta variant. So, overall, it seems that Sputnik V is effective against different variant of concern. However, to a lesser extent. But this is the case with most of the vaccines. So, it is always better to have protection from vaccination rather than no protection without vaccination. That's it for today, guys. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more updates. Thank you.